Hello, hello everyone. This is Eric, RedJet505. So, I keep getting a question all the time all over my videos and in my other channel, RC Monster Garage. And I decided to answer it and explain. And please stay tuned all the way to the end of the video, because this is something that kind of everybody know in the industry and you people don't. And they keep going and spending and wasting money. So, what I'm talking about is the boycott on Traxxas. Yes, we are in our shop. We boycott Traxxas big time. I don't want any of their vehicle ever in my business. I don't want to sell them parts. And no, I'm not losing money. I just don't want to give them any service. Nothing against the customers. I just don't want to give service to their brand. In Tweetweet, their behavior of their customer. And I'm doing it for 20 years, and Traxxas customer assuming that because they spend so much money somewhere else on their vehicle, any hobby shop that they can get into, they can give you a very bad attitude and think that their car is worth millions when they just got ripped off buying those vehicles to start with. And they come with the assumption that I only heard from Traxxas customer, but there is a universal part to fit Traxxas. I don't know where every customer for Traxxas assume that there is a universal part to fit their vehicle, and this is where my video is starting. So, to start with, Traxxas company suing every major company in order to, it's called patent trolling, to prevent people making stuff for them. So there is no universal parts for Traxxas. Although there is a couple company that make parts that will work with their product, but those companies eventually going to get sued, exactly like they sue Venom Battery to produce the plug on their battery that will work on Traxxas because they want everybody to buy only their batteries. In addition, if you go into any group, you will see, for example, on RC group, and it's showing and explain about how the company is established and what become of the company. That the last couple of years it's become to be a corporation, that they are doing what call patent trolling. Let me explain a little bit what is patent trolling. So, for example, Traxxas was suing HPI on a rubber band that sealed the receiver, and this was actually their patent. They claim that they have the patent on it. So they will find something that is not really like a big deal, but they're going to go and sue another company for millions of dollars and take them out of business. So, if you want to fight with someone and you put your boxing gloves, you go into the ring and you're going to fight and the best man win. With the RCA world, if you want to show us that your vehicle is better, bring them to the racetrack and show us that your cars are better. Don't go and sue your competition in order to take them out of business. This is the way that the mob making their business, not actually a honest company. Now, I will get back to it in a second. Please listen to my experience. So, I'm doing this for about like 20 years now, and I have another business of real vehicle, real cars, race cars, and I go to a big show in Vegas called SEMA. The SEMA show in Vegas is a big car show, and you can see a couple videos on my YouTube channel showing the beautiful cars of the and all the upgrade that you can buy every year for your car in this big industry show, showing you everything new. Traxxas have a huge booth over there when they actually not in the automotive industry, but they are there trying to sell the product to other stores, and we're going to get to it in a second. We approached them and approached some of their sales manager and some of their CEO and try to see if we can actually cut a little bit the middleman in order to give you guys a better deal. You guys know right now when you purchase stuff online, it's a little bit cheaper because you buy directly from a company. We're trying to see how we can get directly stuff from a company and sell it to you for the same price in shop. And they refused to even talk to us, told us that we are too small of a business. They don't want to talk to people like us. And literally told us to kind of go away. We don't have any interest, regardless to how much money I'm actually spending. My business is actually pretty good, and they did not really care. At the same time, they will try to sell it to whoever willing to sell their vehicle to big corporations that don't understand what they're doing and think that they're going to have a lot more profit from selling a product that is desirable. So at the beginning, they were selling those vehicles through Pep Boys. And Pep Boys was doing it for a while, and then they discovered the trouble of selling Traxxas, the problem with the warranty and how Traxxas dealing with stuff and all the returns. They kicked them out as fast as they could, just not to deal with Traxxas anymore at Pep Boys. They learned their lesson. They're never going to do this mistake again. Now, you still can buy some stuff from Snap-on. I know that they have some small contract with Snap-on, with one of those guys on the selling it out of their trucks. And it's funny because I'm in Los Angeles and you can see people selling Traxxas on the side street in small tents near gas station. This is how poor this company is. That's individual selling it like a guy selling you oranges on a gas station from the back of a car. I don't know how this guy getting his product, but it's not the point right now. It's just the point about how lame the company is. Now, regarding the boycott and regarding the behavior of Traxxas. So Traxxas through the year sue HPI out of business, sue Great Plains. Great Plains was, as you guys know, it was like the company that actually brought Arma. And they got sued and they got out of business, and then Arma got purchased by Horizon Hobby. And Horizon Hobby at the same time used to be the main distribution center for Traxxas. And of course, it's end up to coming into this that Horizon decided to kick them out also because of their behavior. But a lot of you, the customers, go and spend the money not understanding that you're supporting a company that it's Corporate America that don't really care about you. They're showing you those ridiculous video of a car driving over the water when the car cannot really drive over the water, and most kids drowning the car in the pools just because of a ridiculous video of showing you like X-Max running over the water, okay? In the past, they did the same trick with a car called X01, telling people that it's 100 miles an hour car, but it's actually 55 miles an hour car, and you have to change the gear, and you have to get the small iPod and hook it up to there into the remote in order to jailbreak the speed and make it actually into a fast vehicle. But people are not learning, and people that actually swear by Traxxas, saying that this is the best vehicle ever, and you know what, for me as a shop owner, I'm sending away every day 15 people that come with broken Traxxas car, more than any other vehicle that I have in the store. And I sell a lot of vehicle every day, and none of the vehicle that I sell have that amount of return people with broken stuff. I send those people away because I don't want to give them any service. I'm not losing money. I like to keep my reputation as we don't deal with Traxxas, don't even come here for it. Very simple. And some of their customer getting pissed off and going and giving us bad Yelp, and I don't really care. You know what? I'm not going to support a company that trying to destroy the industry. And let's talk about destroying the industry. So we have company like HPI bankrupt, you have Hobico bankrupt, you have Red Cat Racing got sued for the Terramoto because the Terramoto was having two servo and Traxxas decided that it's copy of their, and they have a patent on two steering servo on a vehicle. This is just being a child and going and breaking the all the toys when someone else come and say, oh yeah, I have the same toys as you. Instead of proving that they have a better product, they actually go and sue the company to create something actually good on a low price that will be affordable for you, the customer. And this is where important, you, the customer. You deserve a good product in a decent price that don't break. All vehicle will break eventually, no matter who is the manufactured. Now, you need to think about if the store near you still sell the product and have the parts. When you get into my shop, you look at the wall and I have almost every parts that you need for any other vehicle. Now, I want to show something simple. Please pay attention now. Okay, Traxxas Slash. And I'm taking the Slash because this is their number one vehicle. This thing have a few different versions, and we're looking here just like in a random store. It's about $500. They're going between $500 to $600, depend where you buy it. And this is for a brushless vehicle, okay? Four-wheel drive, no battery, no charger. The same exact vehicle, okay, that I think that it's even better, gonna be like some of the Arma, and you're gonna go over here, and we're gonna go into this. I'm gonna actually get into to Tower Hobbies. And let's see, it's loading. I just want to show you guys the Arma scent, and I'm not advertising to anybody to go buy it over there. I'm just want to show you that this is kind of exactly the same vehicle as the Slash. This is four-wheel drive. This is the actually newest vehicle. It's come with almost 2 years warranty on some of the electronics. And four-wheel drive, brushless electric, you still need to buy a battery and a charger. And it's going for $180 less than buying the Traxxas. When you're going to contact Horizon Hobby and tell them that there is a problem with this vehicle, they will take care of it right away and send you whatever parts. All the warranties usually go through the manufacturer, not through the stores, and they will take care of it right away. If you're going to look here and you're going to try to contact Traxxas, what I see that they're telling their customers is, what did you do wrong? And this is a big no-no, because they're blaming the customer for their some of their defective product. And I see it with people that will come in here and trying to buy from me a replacement brushless motor, because those blue Villanium motors keep dying on people. And their blue ESC with those single button to do everything on, off, reset, keep actually messing up everybody's cars. So I just want you to understand a little bit about why we boycott them and why we don't like the product and why we're never going to deal with them, no matter what. The fact that they keep suing everybody for everything, this is beyond ridiculous. Now, they have some cars that you see here that they're a little bit cheaper. But whenever you look at those are going to be like, for $200, you're going to get a car that it's actually only like a rear-wheel drive, brushed electric. And there's kind of not a lot of performance out of it. You're going to have to spend much more money in order to make it actually a more fun, usable vehicle. And when you're going into the big stuff, and you go into their X-Max and any of the other vehicle, those vehicles are ridiculously expensive, and they're not better than any other fifth scale vehicle. This is what they want you to think, because they spend millions and millions of dollars on every advertisement everywhere. So please be smart about it. I want you guys to think twice before you even go and buying some of their product. And go and actually do some research in the RC group over here regarding the Traxxas boycott, and see from there. See you on my next video. This is Eric at RC Monster Garage. Bye.